Today, students, welcome to the mathematics class. So here we continue the chapter squares and squares. So in that exercise 6.1. So we have studied the first main question. Now let us see the second question. The following numbers are obviously not perfect square numbers. The following numbers are obviously not a perfect square numbers. Give a reason. Okay, the first one is 1057, second one is 2, 3, 4 by 3, third one is 7928, and fourth one is 222,222. Next. Fifth one is 64,000. Sixth one is 89,722. Seventh 32,310. And eighth question is 50,50,50. So now second question is, what the following numbers are obviously not a perfect square numbers. They have only said that these are not a perfect square numbers. So why those are not a perfect square numbers? Give reason. So I say that when a number will become perfect square, if a number and space of either 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 or 9. If a number ends with 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 or 9, then that will become a perfect square. Otherwise, no. Now let us see, these numbers are anyway, those numbers are what? 7, no. 3, no. 8, no. 2, no. Leave that 0, no. Next, here this is also 2. These numbers, these 5 numbers are not ending with the 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 or 9. Hence, those numbers are not a perfect square numbers. So for that solution is, we will see that about the zeros, ending with 0 number later. Let us see first is, the numbers, one first one, second one, third one, fourth one, and sixth one are not ending with the digits. Ending with digits is 0, 1, 4, 5, 6, or 9. Hence, these are not perfect square numbers. So what is the reason? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 6. These numbers are not ending with the digit 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 or 9. Hence, these are not a perfect square numbers. So now you can ask here. So these three numbers are ending with 0. Then why those are not a perfect squares? So one more thing is there in that, being a square number, perfect square number, if the zeros are even number or the number is ending with even number of zero, then only there will become a what? Perfect square. It should lastly ending with or ends with even number of zero. Like 100 is a perfect square. So it ending with 2 zeros, even number of zero. 10,000, it is a perfect square. It's ending with even number of zeros, 4 zeros. 900, it is ending with even number of zeros. So why these three numbers are not a perfect square means these are ending with odd number of zeros, not even number of zeros. Hence, these are not a perfect square numbers. So let us write that. And the numbers, which are those? Fifth, next, 7, and 8 are ending with there is one pattern, say 11 square which is equals to 121, 101 square which is equals to 100002001. Next, 1001 square. So which is equals to 1002001. 00. Okay. 1410. 1 square. Which is equals to 1-2-1. And similarly, 160. 1 square. Which is equals to 1-1. So after the data, how it is? 11 square equals to 121. 101 square equals to 10201. So 1001 square. So 100. Here also 100, 2001. How many zeros are there? That one zero you will get in the answer. Here it is 3 zeros. So 100001. Here now it is 40. So how many zeros you will get? 4 zeros. 1, 4, 0, 2, 4, 0, 1. So here how many zeros are there? 6. Means you will get how many zeros? 6. So 1, 6 zeros 2, 6 zeros 1. So this is the given pattern. This is about fourth question. Let us see next question, fifth one. Observe the following pattern and supply the missing numbers. Let's see. find the sum. Without adding, find the sum. The first one is 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9. So now without adding you should find the sum. If you add, how much will you get? See, 1 plus 3 4, 4 plus 5 9, 9 plus 7 that is 16, 16 plus 9 25. So now we should not find like this without adding. Means how to find, just see here. How many odd numbers are there? See here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So do the 5 square, you will get the answer. 5 square, that is 25. So how many numbers are there? Do that number square, you will get the answer. So similarly, the second one. 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 15 plus 17 plus 19. So which is equal to? How many numbers are there? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Means 10 square. So what is the answer? 100. So this is how we can find the sum without adding them. Next, third one is, so 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 15 plus 17 plus 19 plus 21 plus 23. So now how many numbers are there? Up to 19, 10 are there. Now another 2 means 12. 12 square. So 12 square, what is the answer? Total sum 144. So square means we should multiply the same number twice. So total sum 144. This is how we need to find the sum without adding the numbers. This is about 7th question. Now let us see next question. Express as sum of 7 odd numbers. So express 49 as sum of 7 odd numbers. Just write the sum of first 7 odd numbers, you will get the 49. That is means 1, next is 3, next 5, next 7, next 9, next 11, next 13. How many it has become? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So these two sum, this sum will give 49. Express 49 as sum of 7 odd numbers. So these are the sum of 7 odd numbers. Next, in that second, express 121 as the sum of 11 odd numbers. Express 121 as the sum of 11 odd numbers. So just write sum of first 11 odd numbers. That is 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 15 plus next 17 plus 19 plus 21. So this will give that 121, sum of 11 odd numbers. So this is about question number 8. Let us see next question. Okay, before going to the last next question, let us take one remark. There are 2n numbers lies between square of the numbers n and n plus 1. Means how many numbers are there between square of 2 and square of 3? How many numbers are there? 2 square is 4 and 3 square is 9. How many numbers are there between 4 and 9? 5, 6, 7, 8. How many are there? 4. This one how we can find means 2n. If you use this formula, you will get. This is like here, 2 is like n. 3 what we can write? 2 plus 1. So here 2 we can have taken as n. So what we can write this one? N plus 1 means in general like square of n square and n plus 1 square. Then we can write the numbers between these two numbers, what? 2n. So if you take that one, 2n. 2 into n means what here? First number, that is 2. 2 into 2, what now? 4. So between any two square of the consecutive number squares, if you want to find the numbers between those two, you can use 2n. That is, there are 2n numbers lie between the square of the numbers n and n plus 1. This should be consecutive. Not like this. If 2 square and 7 square. If asked like this means it won't be useful. It should be consecutive like 2 square and 3 square or 10 square and 11 square. Like that only consecutive number square. Then only we can use this formula. So now, on this only, the next question, that is 8th question, let us see. So what it is, 8th question. How many numbers lie between 12 and 30. So here now square of the following numbers means 12 square and 30 means 13 square. We need to find. So here n means 12 and n plus 1 means 13. So what you can write? The numbers lie between 12 square and 13 square. Which is equals to, what is the formula? 2n, which is equals to 2 into n means first number, that is this one is there, 12. So 2 into 12, which is equals to 24. Therefore, how many numbers are lie between 12 square and 13 square? 24 numbers. So similarly, next second one in there. That is 25 and 26. So the numbers lie between 25 square and 26 square, which is equals to 2n. So 2 into n means first number. How much is that? 25. So 25 2 is 50. Therefore, there are 50 numbers lying between the square of 25 and 26. Similarly, the last one, third, 99 and 100. So the numbers lie between 99 square and 100 square, which is equals to formula is 2n. So 2 into n is first number 99. So what is the answer? 99 2 is 198. Therefore, there are 198 numbers between the square of 99 and 100. So this is about question number 8. By this, the exercise 6.1 is completed. We'll continue in the next class.